Hello everybody, so my talk is essentially about the management of multi-species fisheries, and this work has been done in collaboration with Axel Rosberg. And if you are still wondering what's the connection between the fishing and the issues of biodiversity and MSSD, well, the third descriptor of MSSD, okay, so requires that fishing takes place between safe limits, thus maintaining healthy stocks. But of course, fishing is very much the concern of the common fishery policies, which is working towards implementing this goal of maximum sustainable yield. And I found it quite interesting that this descriptor is the only one from MSSD which is both a state and a pressure descriptor. So it's concerned both with fishing mortalities and stock size. On the other hand, the common fishery policy specifies that these management plans are implemented either in terms of pressure targets or state targets. And actually, as far as I understand, in Europe there is a preference towards the F targets. But besides choosing targets, it's also very important to set an objective. So one option would be, for example, to put all the stocks together and try to get the maximum of the total. And another option would be perhaps to try to get the maximum from each stock separately. And this brings us to the concept of Nash equilibrium, which is taken from the game theory, and is the natural outcome of a game where there is no collaboration between the players. Such a hypothetical game could be played between the managers of fleets, so they are moving by changing their own fishing pressure, they are applying, and if nobody can get any more yield from their fleet by changing their own fishing pressure, this would be an equilibrium state called Nash pressure. Another hypothetical, or even more hypothetical game, would be played between managers of stocks, and they move by changing the size of their stock somehow. So if nobody can get any more yield by changing the size of their own stock, then this would be an equilibrium state we call Nash state. And then for the third objective, which would be the total yield, this is a different kind of game, which requires collaboration between the players because they have to put together their fleets, their stocks, and it might involve some trade-offs between stocks. But in theory, at least, this has the promise of a greater total yield. Right. So we have our three objectives, and we have also the choice of strategy, either using the F targets or the B targets, and by combining this we can define high-level management plans. So there are six combinations, we have six simple management plans, each of them are aiming towards one of the objectives, and it's operating to either the F targets or the B targets. So the way we evaluated these plans was to take a series of food webs. These are abstract food webs, but they are similar in many ways with the marine community, so they have complex interactions. Species are structured on several trophic levels, and each food web has a few thousand species, of which around 30 are fish, well, abstract fish, I think, have their own cubic fish, maybe. So what did we compare in our evaluation of these management strategies? Of course, we wanted to see how much yield we get, but also, we wanted to see if how many species survive, or how many fish species go extinct with this management plan. And if they go extinct, we wanted to see if this is affecting disproportionately more the larger fish, because it's very easy to get high yield by killing the top predator. So how much yield are you getting? Well, these are the results for the F targets, and I'm not sure what is your impression, but I was quite disappointed if you look at the Nash state is going to get in like a third. And also the total yield is not a clear winner. So if we bring in the results for the B targets, now you can see there is a large improvement in the yield for every single objective. And actually now the total yield objective is getting close to 85%, so it's a clear winner. But then you may wonder if there is a cost to getting so much yield. Well, so if you look how many species went extinct, well, quite a few. So these are the survival rates. There are two interesting facts here. First, that the Nash state, so the one which was not giving large yields, actually at least is very good at preserving the species. And also that the B targets, which were producing more yield than the F targets, are also better at protecting the species. So all three of them have higher survival rates. And we'll get soon the third metric, which is giving us an insight how the community size structure is changing. So if we are preferentially killing the larger species. So again, the Nash state in the middle is a clear winner, so it's not producing a lot of yield, but at least it's preserving well the community size structure. And the B targets, okay, they show a reduction in this mean body mass, but this is very slight. So I hope I was well. So the idea is that, okay, we can have a plan which can produce a lot of yield, but then perhaps we have to accept some trade-offs in terms of survival, in terms of the change in community size structure. The fact is that we didn't have any conservation constraints imposed in our very simple plans. So then we were wondering, like, what if we bring in a simple constraint, say that any stock which drops to 10% of its original virgin biomass, we stop fishing, allow it to recover. So then let's see what would happen, at least for this plan. We modify then the management plans, we work on the simulations again. And we should see the results in a moment. Right, so amazingly, the total yield didn't decrease, so we get the same yield. But then it's a large increase in the survival, so more less extinctions, and also the community size structure is improved quite a lot. So this was just a brief insight into my work and with Axel, and my take-home message would be that the state targets are outperforming the national targets in terms of yields, and not only that, in principle, it would be possible to protect the biodiversity without compromising the yields. And for more details, they can be found in my paper with Axel, which I published earlier this year. It also explains the mechanism why we believe that the state targets are performing better than the pressure targets. And I would like to thank devotees for the support, although this work was not part of the project, essentially, and everybody has contributed. Thank you very much for your attention.